Today we'll discuss about physiology of micturition. Micturition is the process by which urinary bladder empties. It begins at about 5th month of intrauterine life and it is reflex until 2 to 2.5 years of life. Physiological events in the micturition includes filling of the urinary bladder and emptying of the urinary bladder. Starting with filling of urinary bladder. Urine is continuously formed in the nephrons and it is transported through ureter into the urinary bladder. When urine collects in the pelvis of the ureter, the contractions sets up in the pelvis and these contractions they are transmitted by peristaltic wave at a rate of about 3 cm per second. When the ureter enters in the urinary bladder, there is valvular arrangement. This valve pushes the urine towards the bladder and this is one-way valve. Increased pressure in the pelvis, it initiates peristaltic contractions. The velocity of contraction is about 3 cm per second and they occur once every 2 to 3 minutes. Capacity of urinary bladder. Physiological capacity of urinary bladder at birth, that is 20 to 50 ml. At 1 year, it becomes 200 ml and in adult, it is 600 ml. Whereas anatomical capacity is 1000 ml. Anatomical capacity is the capacity beyond which bladder ruptures. Cystometrogram. When bladder fills, there is change in the pressure of the bladder with change in the volume and graphical representation of pressure changes in the urinary bladder in relation to volume changes, that is cystometrogram. Cystometry is the technique used to demonstrate the relationship between intravesical pressure and intravesical volume. Method of recording for that double lumen catheter is introduced into the urinary bladder. One lumen is used to infuse fluid into the bladder and other lumen is used to record pressure changes by connecting this lumen to recording instrument. And this kind of graph is obtained. When we plot intravesical pressure and intravesical volume, and this graphical recording is known as cystometrogram. Now, normal cystometrogram. It has three segments, segment 1A, 1B and 2. Now, segment 1A, here the volume of fluid in the bladder rises from 0 to 100. And as the volume rises up to 0 to 100 ml, the intravesical pressure rises from 0 to 10 cm of water. You can see here in the graph. Segment 1B, it shows plateau part. Here, volume of fluid in the bladder increases from 100 ml to about 300 to 400 ml. But the pressure remains just above or below 10 cm of water. And that is because of property of plasticity as well as Laplace law. As we all know, according to Laplace law, pressure is equal to tension divided by radius. So as the volume increases, it increases tension. But along with that, stretching results in increase in the radius and therefore there is no further increase in the pressure. Segment 2. Here, when the volume increases more than 400 ml, there is sharp increase in the pressure. And here, this is because there is no further increase in the radius of the bladder. Therefore, pressure rises sharply. Now, in this graph, these are micturition waves or micturition contractions. Here, these waves, they are superimposed on the tonic pressure changes when bladder fills. And that is because of P periodic acute rise in the pressure, and they last for few seconds or more than a minute. They are result of stretch reflex, which is initiated by stretch receptors in the urinary bladder and urethra. Micturition reflex. Micturition occurs by reflex process, and the reflex is known as micturition reflex. As we have discussed in cystomatogram, when intravesical pressure rises above 40 cm of water or volume of urine rises above 300 to 400 ml, that is stimulation of stretch receptors, they are present on the urinary bladder and urethra. Afferent impulses, they pass via pelvic parasympathetic nerves, and these impulses, they go to the sacral segments S2, S3, S4, and efferent impulses, they also pass via pelvic parasympathetic nerves, and this pelvic parasympathetic nerves, they cause contraction of detrusor muscles and relaxation of internal urethral sphincter. Now, urine enters in the urethra, and here now there is stimulation of stretch receptors in the urethra, and this also sends afferent impulses to the spinal cord via pelvic nerves. Along with that, if there is inhibition of the pudendal nerve, you can see here, pudendal nerve supplies external urethral sphincter. So when the pudendal nerve also gets inhibited, then that results in voiding of urine. Once the micturition reflex starts, it is regenerative reflex. Initial contraction of urinary bladder activates stretch receptors, and it causes further increase in the sensory inputs from the bladder as well as urethra. And this increases force of contraction of urinary bladder each time. And when the micturition reflex becomes powerful enough, it sets another reflex, and the reflex passes through the pudendal nerve to external urethral sphincter, and it inhibits pudendal nerve. Inhibition of the pudendal nerve is more potent in the brain than voluntary constrictor signals. They pass to the external urethral sphincter, and that results in urination. And if it is not possible, urination will not occur until bladder fills further. Now, role of various higher centers for micturition. As we have discussed, micturition reflex is a spinal reflex, but it is facilitated as well as inhibited by various centers present in the brain, and they are known as supraspinal centers. Inhibitory centers for micturition, they are located in midbrain and cerebral cortex, whereas facilitatory centers, they are present in pons and posterior hypothalamus. These higher centers, they keep the micturition reflex partially inhibited, and the micturition reflex sets in when it is desired to micturate. Suprapontine centers, they relay their influence on sacral micturition centers, and that is through pontine micturition center, and these centers are present in cerebral cortex, basal ganglia and limbic system. Now we discuss role of various perineal and abdominal muscles in micturition. At the time of micturition, there is relaxation of levator ani and perineal muscles, and that results in shortening of posterior urethra and decrease in the urethral resistance. There is also descent of diaphragm, and abdominal muscles, they also contract, which increases intra-abdominal pressure, and which in turn increases intravesical pressure. So this is all about physiology of micturition. Thank you.